Hello, my name is Dr. Jacob Graham, and this is the fifth video in the Species Counterpoint series. Here we will discuss third species rules and conventions, which involve composing four notes against a given note. Before we get there, though, we have to cover the 3-to-1 rhythmic proportion, which I guess you could call the second and a half fifth species counterpoint. Fuchs doesn't give triple meter its own species in Gradus ad Parnassum, but sandwiches it between the chapters on second and third species. After that, we'll cover the special rules concerning third species, including the accented passing tone and nota cambiata, and end the video by going again over the cadence conventions for this species. To start, here is a perfectly good measure of second species counterpoint. We begin with a third on the downbeat and leap up to a perfect fifth on the upbeat. Remember from our previous video on second species that passing tones could be inserted between melodic leaps of a third, sort of like we have here. If we were to add the passing tone C between B and D, we would get something that looks like this. Now, we have three notes against one in the cantus firmus. However, the first two notes of the counterpoint are quarter notes, and the third is a half note. If we were to equalize the notes of the counterpoint, we would arrive at a real 3-to-1 rhythmic proportion. We now have a genuine triple meter, with three equal notes of the counterpoint relating to one of the cantus. Notice how we created a measure of triple meter by adding a diminution, in this case a dissonant passing tone, to an otherwise good measure of second species duple meter. You may not have noticed it at the time, but this is the same trick we used in the previous video when we added a dissonant passing tone between two otherwise good measures of first species to create a measure of second species. I encourage you to revisit that video if the role of diminutions in creating new rhythmic situations isn't clear. Another option for creating a 3-to-1 rhythmic proportion is to have all three notes of the counterpoint form consonant relationships to the cantus firmus. It is pretty easy to compose in second and a half fifth species because these are the only two options. Either A, the first and third beats are consonant, and the second beat is a dissonant passing tone between them, or B, all three beats are consonant. So now on to third species, where we have a proportion of four notes against one. The simplest instance of this is shown here. Just like in the previous species, the metrical pattern of accents determines what we are able to do on each beat. Let's label our measure of quadruple meter to show each of the four beats and the relative strengths of their accents. The number of dashes underneath each beat represents how strong the beat is compared to the others. Beat one has the strongest accent, and just like in first and second species, we can only put consonant intervals on the downbeat. Beats 2 and 4 are the weakest beats, and we can put either consonances or dissonant passing tones on these beats, like in this example. Beat 3 is weaker than beat 1, but stronger than beats 2 and 4. We usually put consonances on beat 3, but there's a special exception where we can put a dissonant passing tone on beat 3, which we call the accented passing tone. This should look familiar. It's the same measure of triple meter we looked at earlier, where all three notes of the counterpoint are consonances with the cantus firmus. We're going to use the same trick of inserting a new dissonant passing tone between melodic notes separated by the leap of a third. That will take us from a 3-to-1 triple meter to a 4-to-1 quadruple meter. When we equalize the notes this time, though, the passing tone will end up on the relatively strong beat 3. And so, unlike previous passing tones, this one will have a metrical accent. Let's add the diminution between the leap from D to B in the counterpoint. And now, with the diminution added, let's equalize the note values into quarter notes. And now we have a measure of 4-to-1 counterpoint with an accented passing tone on beat 3. Notice that, as always, beat 1 is a consonant, and that in order to create the dissonance on beat 3, both of the weak beats, beat 2 and beat 4, had to be consonant. Now for the nota cambiata, Italian for exchanged note. This is a dissonance that is not a passing tone. Take the seventh on beat 2 of this example. It is approached by step, but it is left by leap in the same direction. Then on beat 4, the leap is recovered in the opposite direction, and we obtain the note B that our dissonance would have resolved to if it had been a passing tone. That's the short definition of a cambiata, and believe me, there are much more convoluted definitions out there. The cambiata does not fit very naturally into Fuchs's theory, and he had to go down something of a rabbit hole to rationalize it in terms of diminutions. He includes it in Gradus anyway, though, because, as he says, the old masters have approved its use. Finally, let's look at the cadence conventions for third species. There are three possible cadences. Option A features a penultimate measure that ascends through the harmonic interval pattern 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, and octave. Option B is to have a cambiata in the penultimate measure, with the interval pattern octave, 7th, 5th, 6th, octave. Option C is the only option when the counterpoint is in the lower voice. Here we use the pattern 3rd, 5th, 4th, 3rd, unison. Now that we know all of the rules and conventions, let's listen to the example that Fuchs gives for third species. Most of the measures are of the normal third species type, where the only dissonances are passing tones on beats 2 and 4. Fuchs throws in one cambiata in measure 3, and two accented passing tones in measures 7 and 9. We should aim for a similar kind of variety of dissonance types in our exercises. Here are three new cantus firmae that you can use to practice 4-to-1 or 3-to-1 counterpoint. In the next video, we'll be discussing fourth species, which introduces dissonances on the downbeat of the measure.